Series is tied 2-2, Celtics and Cavs. LeBron James had 44 points, monster game. Passes Kareem on the all-time field goals, playoff makes. Congratulations to LeBron. Congratulations to the Cavs. They fought themselves back into the series. Game 3, they punched them in the mouth. In Game 4, they punched the Celtics in the mouth again. Celtics didn't have an answer for it. It was not like the Cavs played extremely well. Overall, it was a pretty evenly matched game in terms of the other numbers. For example, free throws, shooter percentage from three. Celtics only made one more three than the Cavs. Cavs gained an edge, though. Rebounding-wise, they out-rebounded them like 60-45. And they got 9 offensive rebounds, which were extra possessions for the Cavs. And it took time off the clock. Cavs had a lead, and they just kept taking time off the clock. So that really hurt the Celtics. And that just goes to youth, because Celtics don't know how to value possessions. And that's the problem when you play young teams and have young players. They just don't understand. Take your time. Get the mismatch. Run the play. You know, certain plays for the Celtics, they were down 15, 12, 11. They would try to jack up a quick three instead of running a play that could get them a great two. With the Celtics, though, this is a game that they're going to regret, because Kevin Love didn't play well. J.R. Smith didn't really play well. Tristan Thompson and George Hill had 13 points, like, and Kyle Korver at 14. Like, nobody else really played a great game besides LeBron James. So this is a game where if you play solid and like you normally do in the Garden, you would have won this game. But simple fact is they didn't. And now they got a 2-2 series. The Cavs, I think Cavs know they could win one in Boston. So this game 5 is pivotal. To me, whoever wins game 5 wins the series. And I know people are like, well, it's the home team is always winning and they're holding serve and playoffs doesn't begin until the home team loses a game on their court. But to me, it all boils down to this. The team that wins the next game is going to have all the confidence and they're going to want to close out the team. Nobody wants to see a game 7. Celtics don't want to see a game 7. Cavs don't want to see a game 7. Because if the Cavs go play a game 7 in the Celtics building, they're not going to get all those calls they would get in game 3 and 4. Game 3 and 4, honestly speaking, when you're watching it, especially game 4, they let LeBron James play a little bit of football out there with the push-offs, when he's backing down guys, elbowing guys, slapping guys in the face. I mean, if that's in Boston and that's a game 7, they're going to call those offensive fouls, and that's going to hurt the Cavs' chances. Also, you don't know what you're going to get from a George Hill, from a Tristan Thompson, from a Kyle Korver game 7. Like, stuff like that might freak them out, especially if it's on the Celtics court. So the game 5 is very pivotal. Like, if the Celtics go and win, I think that gives them enough confidence to come back to Cleveland, actually play a regular game and try to win it. Like, play a regular game, because they've been in Cleveland, they just can't get off the mat against Cleveland in Cleveland. Makes no sense. Absolutely. I don't know if it's the fans that's rattling them, I don't know what it is, but they can't get off the mat. But vice versa, if the Cavs win in Boston, oh yeah, they're like, yeah, we're going to close them out at home, and we're going to go to the NBA Finals, and that's that. So we'll see how it plays out. It's really sad that the Celtics can't play on the road. Like, that's really, really sad. Like, the one game they won on the road against Philly, because Philly made a bunch of mistakes. And that's the thing. The Cavs aren't going to make those mistakes that Philly did. So Brad Stevens has to do a game plan and improvise a little bit. Sometimes you have to show guys what they do well and just tell them to keep doing that. Don't get out of character. You saw Al Horford get out of character drilling in the midst of 5-4 guys. You saw Jaylen Brown get out of character jacking up quick shots when, you know, he knows, you know, run down the clock, run the play, run the options. But, you know, you just got to show the guys what they do well and get them back in their happy place, like Happy Gilmore. As far as the Cavs, they're in great shape, because when they were up 2-0, they put a lot of pressure on them to win both games on their home court, and they did just that, and that's what they needed. So this potentially could go 7, but to me, whoever wins this next game wins the series. Let me know what you think in the comments below.